The peripatetic Duryea. The complex history of Charles and J. Frank Duryea is well known and it is available in detail on the internet. Frank Duryea is said to have made the first production automobile. The car was released in 1893 for demonstration, and in 1895 the Duryea Motor Wagon Company produced cars as regular production in Springfield, Massachusetts. The history of the manufacturing movement with the Duryea name, let's call them Duryea Motor Producers, is too complicated to reiterate. But it is interesting that as they moved around the country, Charles produced a sales brochure wherever he landed. We have copies of the Duryea Motor Company brochures with different names and several different locations with the covers illustrated here. The first brochure, printed around 1898, was when the car was made in Springfield, Massachusetts. This is really a remarkable brochure for several reasons. It announces that on Thanksgiving Day in 1895, a Duryea completed and won the first prize in the Chicago Times Herald race. This is considered the earliest competition of its type in the United States. It was followed by a win in the famous London to Brighton race. But even more remarkable, this brochure offered for the first time ever a purpose-built production racing wagon. Our brochure collection shows no other production racing cars for sale in the United States until several years later. At this point in time, the company seemed to be flourishing with this multi-page brochure and a variety of interesting models. However, around this time, Charles and J. Frank Duryea split. J. Frank Duryea went on to greater heights by working with the Stevens Duryea Company, who for a while produced high-quality automobiles before they folded in the 1920s. Charles took over. He produced this brochure extolling the events of the cars and indicating that they were making all kinds of motor vehicles. In the meantime, probably 1905, he ends up in Reading, Pennsylvania, where he produced the Buggy Out, in this brochure selling for $750. However, around the same time, he introduced an ambitious brochure with several models of manufacture made by the Waterloo Motor Works in Waterloo, Iowa. They also had factories in Reading, Pennsylvania. This advanced three-wheel design was a large Surrey with most impressive features. In 1905, they began producing cars in Coventry, England. The extensive brochure not only goes into the history of the Duryea car since its beginning, but also has 64 pages of mechanical detail and justification for its use. Then, in 1911, we find Charles in Saginaw, Michigan. The Duryea Motor Company produced this brochure with the most advanced design, including a front engine, but still with solid rubber tires. By 1915, we find the Duryea Motor Sales Company, as shown in this pamphlet, with headquarters in New York, being produced by the Cresson Morris Company in Philadelphia, who also had offices in Rochester, New York. That year, they just made a cycle car. The last year, brochure shows the Duryea Jow, a three-wheeler with pneumatic tires, being produced in Wilmington, Delaware. The Crowler Duryea Company in Rochester, New York, folded in 1917. After this, Charles went back to Reading to make the last Duryea gem. This completes our collection of Duryea brochures and shows the mysterious way in which the name or the company moved around in a manner far more difficult to understand so many years later.